coming out tonight and being a part of the show. Again, we have David Bussing performing again. He performed about 2 weeks ago, did a great show, great singer, great songwriter. We're fortunate to have him back tonight again. We hope you enjoy his music. And hi, Mom. That's not me. No problem, that happens. But again, a wonderful, talented young man. We're fortunate to have him back here to Huber again. I want to thank the Huber for hosting it again tonight. We have HIX-TV here filming again. We appreciate them being here. I want to thank Ron Jones, Mayor Ron Jones, for helping sponsor this and being a part of this. But we also have Hicksville Bank as a main sponsor, Farmers and Merchants Bank, SMTA, and Pat King with King Insurance. So thank you to the sponsors and everybody that participates. Come on down tonight. We have Fat Pig Barbecue Smokehouse doing some food. So enjoy the show. Thank you. Thanks, David.
All right, thanks for coming out tonight. I'm David Bussing. Thank you to the Hicksville Chamber of Commerce having me out here a couple times this summer. And I know there's a few of you who came out last time. I'm gonna tell some stories, don't really have a script or set or anything, just gonna kind of roll with it. But this first tune here is by one of my favorite songwriters from Nashville. This is a song by Chris Stapleton. It's called Broken Halos.
I've seen my share of broken halos. Folded wings that used to fly, and they've all gone wherever they go. Broken halos that used to shine. Angels come down. Broken halos.
Chris Davidson. Just going to do some originals tonight and trying to think of some ones I didn't do last time. One thing I'm really into is family history, and started asking my grandparents and my parents, like, hey, how'd you all meet, you know? And I guess when they're telling me the stories, I just kind of thought, you know, the ways of old are a little different than now, obviously, but I just put this song together. It's kind of about how they all met, I guess. Really not much else to say about it.
Papa was a gambler and he met the Rolling Stones. So how he lit a fire inside my mom's soul. High school sweets don't learn to run by rules. Kids together really know the golden rule. Hometown boy played baseball till the dust. The light in his heart was the leather in the dust. I saw the foam starter in the bleacher by the park. His heart gave the way to the future and the spark. So lay me down to stories of holy water. Cause ways of old are miracles to me. And no one's sure what we're doing here. And nothing sounds like the silence there. Days of now are the old about to be. Through the store about a million miles a beat. His chest starts thumping and his fingers sweat the heat. The girl behind the counter is the center of the piece. The street view window is a place for eyes to greet. So lay me down to stories of holy water. Ways of old are miracles to me. And no one's sure what we're doing here. And nothing sounds like the silence there. The days of now are the old about to be. Stationed in Texas where the boys come back from war. The waitress makes a living and sleeps there on the floor. Nowhere else to go, so they drink till the morning. Two kids together only worry about their own. Two kids together only know the golden rule. So lay me down to stories of holy water. Cause ways of old are miracles to me. No one's sure what we're doing here. And nothing sounds like the silence there. No one's sure what we're doing here. And nothing sounds like the silence there. The days of now are the old about to be. The days of now are the old about to be.
There about a station in Texas. My grandpa was a Korean War vet. He'd got back home, and my grandma was a waitress in Texas. I mean, she's more Texas than in Texas. I mean, the stereotypes, I mean, she was it. And they got together and came back here to Ohio for some reason. And, that's where my grandpa was from. So. One of my grandma's favorite artists was Elvis Presley. And my grandpa kind of resembled Elvis. I mean, more in his hair and everything, you know, than maybe his looks. But had the slicked hair going on, and had just come back from war. But she liked Elvis so much, she had the velvet Elvises, on the wall, and she'd order all the Time Life plates and everything. And, so last time I played out, my aunt was like, "Hey, why don't you play a song the grandma would like?" So I was like, "Well, this is the only one I know that I could play." So
you ain't nothing but a dog, crying all the time. You was high class. Well, that was just a lie. They said you was high class. Well, that was just a lie. Well, you ain't ever caught a rabbit, and you ain't no friend of mine. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, yeah, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, yeah, crying all the time.
Saw Garth Brooks last summer, about a year ago, I think, Notre Dame. I told her, "Hey, he never plays this song live. I wonder why." And fortunately, on the show we went to, finally played it. But it was a little Garth Brooks song. his little original about becoming an adult here. It's called Growing My Own Wheel. Favorite band, bands from the 70s. It's a band called Thin Lizzy. Kind of categorized as an Irish folk rock band. The lead singer, Phil Lynott, his mom was a pub owner, and she would have these guys. They were like a clique of guys. They called it, they were considered a gang, but not like in the sense that you usually think. They're just a bunch of guys that kind of ran around loose. And every once in a while, these guys would get in trouble and get locked up. And they'd all go at the same time, but then they'd all get out together. And he wanted to write a song about these guys and how when these guys came back, the word went around and everybody knew that they were coming back and to watch out. And so he wrote a song called The Boys Back in Town. It was like this. Oh.
much to say. But man, I still think them cats are crazy. They were asking if you were around, how you was, where you could be found. I told them they were living downtown, driving all the old men crazy. Because the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town. I said the boys are back in town. When I tell you she was cool, she was red hot. I mean she was steaming. And that time back at Johnny's place, when that chick got up and she slapped Johnny's face. Man, we just fell about the place. She don't wanna know, man, forget her. Cause the boys are back in town. I said the boys are back in town. The boys are back in town.
Favorite artist is a guy called James Taylor. He's got really a kind of cool picking style with his fingers. Kind of started learning his songs and how he played, and kind of taught me a lot on how to do some finger pick style guitar. But he wrote a song on his first album, or after his first album, about missing home. And he's from North Carolina, and he got a little homesick, and so he wrote the song called Carolina on My Mind. It goes like this.
In my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? It ain't it like a friend of mine me from behind. Said I'm going to Carolina in my mind. Karen sees the silver sun. You best walk away and watch her shine. Watch her watch the morning come. Silver of a tear appearing now, and I'm crying, and I said I'm going to Carolina in my mind. Now there ain't no doubt in no one's mind that love's the finest thing around. Whisper something soft and kind. Hey babe, the sky's on fire and I'm crying, and I'm going to Carolina in my mind. In my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? Ain't it like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Said I'm going to Carolina in my mind. Dark and silent late last night, I think I might have heard that highway call. Geese in flight and dogs that bite. The signs that might be omens say I'm going to Carolina in my mind. Host of others standing around me, still I'm on the dark side of the moon. And it seems like it goes on like this forever. You must forgive me if I'm up and gone to Carolina in my mind. In my mind, I'm going to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Said I'm going to Carolina in my mind. I'm going to Carolina in my mind.
Let's do a fun song. So, first job I ever had was I was a lifeguard in high school. Just kind of did that during the summers. I played a lot of sports, but after I graduated, I kind of had some time for, had to go back to school again, and need a little money in my pocket, so I went and worked in a factory, and I worked in that factory for 20 years. But I was in this Christian rock band at the time, and one thing we like to do is we always like to write goofy songs all the time. We'd kind of do our praise and worship thing, and some of our more meaningful things, and then we'd do a goofy song. And my first year working in a factory, I made some observations, and this is the first song I ever wrote. I'm kind of embarrassed to play it. But it's called the factory song. It goes like this. Working during the summer's kind of a bummer. There's no time for fun and games. The graveyard shift's racking my brain. Throw it on the conveyor, see what they pay her. 'Cause working in a factory is common sense, simplicity, and all I know is I wanna go home. Watch out for your supervisor. He's gonna try and get you fired. Don't you listen to that lazy bum. He used to have the same job as you. Working during the summer's kind of a bummer. There's no time for fun and games or graveyard
branches, racking my brain, throw it on the conveyor, see what you pay. Cause working in a factory is common sense, simplicity. And all I know is I wanna go home. Fell asleep on the couch again. How much longer must this go on? I wake up, check the calendar. 4 more weeks till I'm back on days. 4 more weeks till I'm back on days. Here we go, working in the summer's kind of a bummer. There's no time for fun and games and graveyard shifts, racking my brain, throwing on the conveyor, see what the payer. Working in a factory is common sense, simplicity. And all I know is I wanna go home. Factory song. By Ben Harper. Well, I put into Nashville, Tennessee. You would never come around to see me. But if you're heading up to Carolina, you know I'm always gonna be right there behind you. Always have to steal my kiss from you. Always have to steal my kiss from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I love the feel of that warm summer rain. To see it fall's the sweetest sounding thing. Fall on that simple country dress. It's like heaven to me, I must confess. And I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. You walk away. Oh no, you didn't mean that. No, I love the way you think, but I hate the way you act. And I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you. I always have to steal my kisses from you. Always have to steal my kisses from you.
I originally grew up in Paulding, Ohio. Met my wife, and we moved to Hicksville, her hometown. Recently, I didn't realize how much roots I had in Hicksville before I moved here. My great aunt and uncle were Kenny Smitley and Jerry Smitley. And Jerry's still alive and kicking. I think she's 102. But Kenny was a World War II vet, B inspector for Defiance County over 40 years. But his wife, Jerry, her brother, was a radio gunner in World War II. It's part of a group called the Burma Bridge Busters. And went on 53 missions. They would fly over the Himalayas and try to cut off, get supplies over to China because supply line's been cut off. But when he passed his estate, he had letters home, and family kind of distributed the letters a little bit and kind of left a few over. And so I wanted to read the letter he wrote home to his parents. This was kind of when things were winding down. He'd already been on quite a few missions, and he was kind of waiting to come home. This is from Columbia, South Carolina. Dear Mom and Dad, your latest letter arrived yesterday afternoon. I was very glad to get it. I imagine you're getting a little disgusted at me for not writing often or two. For 2 or 3 days, I didn't get any mail. And I just didn't write any either. I received a box of cookies from Doris, his wife, yesterday. We enjoyed them too. As for your sending me a box, perhaps you better not send it right away. We really don't know when we may be moved or when or if we will get a furlough, which is a break off your active duty. I would hate to have you send me a box and then have it get stale trying to catch up with me. Things are rather unsettled at the present moment. Confidentially, we have almost finished the depot training. We may get furloughs any day now. Then again, we may have to wait around here and do KP, which is kitchen duty. Another detail indefinitely. Please don't think I have a reason for not wanting you to send anything at the present time. I would much rather come home and eat the food. Food here isn't bad. We were just spoiled at Yuma, Arizona. The day we had KP, Thursday, we really ate all we wanted. KP here isn't so bad. We didn't get up until 5 o'clock a.m. and got off about 7:30 p.m., so we didn't mind it much. I guess 14 and a half hours ain't too bad of a work day back then. The hours were long enough, though. It rained very hard here last night. The soil was sandy, though, so it isn't so muddy. They gave us a little trouble yesterday. They put a sign on the bulletin board saying, all furloughs and passes canceled until further notice. Boy, did we gripe. However, we got passes to town last night, so I guess it didn't amount to much. It would be my luck to have them canceled again. I hope not, and won't give up hope until it actually happens. Dad, I'm glad to hear you're collecting fish bait. I ran across 4,005 big fat crickets yesterday. Also a 5-foot rattlesnake. The snake had been killed though. If he hadn't been, there would have been a new speed record set, and I don't mean maybe. I'll close for now. Give everyone my regards. Hope to see you soon. That's Love, Eddie. Ed West. What I liked about that letter, kind of makes me feel spoiled a little bit. Just the maturity he had, I think, in writing for a guy in his early 20s, you know. Their family lived right down on Spencerville Street, and I just thought that was cool to actually put to life something our town kind of has a background in, and actually read a letter from him. But another person in my history was an Irish guy named John Toomey. He came to Canada and got a stipend to bring his horse down in the Civil War. I kind of took that story from him and made one of my own about a brother who gets a letter from his other brother. And his brother's in battle and he can't leave his brother behind, so he has to go take his horse to the cavalry lines and meet his brother at the first camp he can. So this song's called Cavalry Lines.
A postmark from brother used to love all his letters. It's this one read me right to my bones. Cause the ground soaked with blood under hazes above makes a soul wonder what he's become. The cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I'll meet you at the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I'll meet you at the cavalry lines. Homes built from love and our cattle full grown. Every year we've reaped well what we've sown. And my boy beats the drum to the tune of my hum. Pray he never plays the battlefield lines, the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I'll meet you at the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I'll meet you at the cavalry lines. How to muster my courage. Now my muster's in record just to see to the ends of those lines. Waterford and Norman will be my home in the morning. Captain Campbell has my saddle blue dyes. Cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. Meet you at the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I meet you at the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I meet you at the cavalry lines. Cavalry lines, the cavalry lines. I'll meet you at the cavalry lines.
Friend over there, Bob Weatherhead, him and I are in a little group together. Called the Wannabes. You haven't heard of us? One of the best guys I know right there. Like a brother figure to me. I don't know so much about a father figure. I don't know if, you know, you're kind of ornery, so. A brother figure. But, one of the guys we do a lot of his stuff is Chris Stapleton. Really good songwriter, probably one of the best songwriters of time right now. But a favorite that we do is a song called Tennessee Whiskey, which was actually written by an old country singer named George Jones. And I never heard the song by George Jones until Chris Stapleton brought it alive, but it goes like this. My nights out in a barroom,
liquor was the only love I've ever known. Yeah. But you rescued me from reaching for the bottom and pulled me back from being too far gone. Oh, as smooth as Tennessee whiskey, your aura is sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy, and honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time. I've looked for love in all the same old places, haven't we all? And found the bottom of the bottles always dry. But when you poured out your love, you know I didn't waste it, because there's nothing like your love to get me high. Oh, as smooth as Tennessee whiskey, your aura is sweet as strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass of brandy, and honey, I stay stoned on your love all the time. You're as smooth as Tennessee whiskey. It's Tennessee whiskey. It's Tennessee whiskey. Oh, it's smooth. It's Tennessee whiskey. It's Tennessee whiskey. It's Tennessee whiskey.
Chris Stapleton, love that guy. Song in 1977 was a song written by Bob Seger, and he wanted to write a song about the Midwest and what life like a kid was in the Midwest. And he was from Bob, was he from Detroit? Detroit, Michigan, he's from. And you know, that's about as Midwest you can get for the 70s, the automotive industry and all that going on. But he said, hey, I hear all these songs about people talking about where they live, you know, all these places. So he wanted to write one about summer in the Midwest, and wrote a little song called Night Moves. It goes like this. It's a little too tall. A few pounds, top pants, points, all of it now. She was a black-haired beauty with big dark eyes, points of her own, sitting way up high. Way up firm and high. Past the cornfields where the woods got heavy, out in the back seat of my 60 Chevy. Working on mysteries without any clues. Working
sitting on the lamppost, trying to make some front page driving news, working on the lamppost in summertime. Funny how the night moves, just don't seem to have as much to lose. Strange how the night moves, but I'm closing in.
Original called Takes Time. It's a just a song about appreciating life, appreciating who you spend it with, living in the moment, all the above. It's kind of self-explanatory, called Takes Time.
This book's from your grandma's treasury. Open up the cover. Easy, there's a lot we need to see. It'll take time, takes time. Mom and Dad split when she was three. Built a whole life on a broken dream. 4 more years of school, go alone in that degree. It'll take time, time. No story's guaranteed, but the pages in between. Oh, it takes time. Don't let it pass you by. Settle in and take the ride. It takes time. It takes time. Last time you talked to God back in 83, the sun was blazing hot through the summer streets. Lost boys went for gold, then the flood rains chilled the coals. What a time, it was a hell of a time. Oh, it takes time. No story's guaranteed, but the pages in between. Oh, it takes time. Don't let it pass you by. Settle in and take the ride. It takes time. It takes time. It takes time. It takes time. Story's guaranteed, but the pages in between. Oh, it takes time. Don't let it pass you by. Settle in and take the ride. One more week of treatments, then we're free. We can drive together. What a strange disease. Turn up the radio, we'll sing every song you know. We got time, still got time. Oh, still got time. No story's guaranteed, but the stage is in between. Oh, still got time. Don't let it pass us by. Buckle in and take the ride. It takes time. It takes time. It takes time. It takes time.
Nice little cozy audience out here. Got any requests out there? Bob, you got a request? No? I'll just keep playing them. Let's do a little love song. I haven't done a love song. So here
ego is nothing, in case you didn't know. Baby, I'm crazy about you, and I would be lying if I said that I could live this life without you. Even though I don't tell you all the time, you had my heart a long, long time ago. In case you didn't know. The way you look tonight, that second glass of wine. Something about that kiss, girl, that did me in. Got me thinking, yeah, I'm thinking, all of the things that I've been feeling. Oh, it's time you hear them, in case you didn't know. I would be lying if I said that I could live this life without you. Even though I don't tell you all the time, you had my heart a long, long time ago. In case you didn't know, you have all of me, and I belong to you. Yeah, you're my everything. I'm crazy about you, and I would be lying if I said that I could live this life without you. Even though I don't tell you all the time, you had my heart a long, long time ago. You had my heart a long, long time ago. In case you didn't know.
Brett Young. Is that Brett Young? Yes, I think it's Brett Young. But I mentioned I'm originally from Pawling, Ohio. I grew up in Pawling, Ohio. And it's about the same size as Hicksville. Most people are probably familiar with Pawling. It's not far away. But the thing about Pawling is the mosquitoes are terrible. Everything in Pawling just runs along the Flat Rock Creek. And there's just certain kind of people that just get eaten up by mosquitoes, and I'm one of them. I don't know what it is. If they're vampires, if there's such thing, I'd be the first one to go. But thing with Paulding is it's kind of got a little more a lot of trees and kind of swampy area in it. You know, it used to be the center of the Black Swamp, but one thing my sister and I always do is we'd go fish off the bridge, and the Flat Rock Creek was so packed with fish that you pretty much put your line in, and it wasn't a minute or two later you'd get something. But it usually just end up being a blob of mud, some weird bottom-dwelling catfish or something, you know. But there's a song I always heard in the car with my dad. I used to like listening to oldie stations. And this song always reminded me of Pawling a bit. Goes like this.
Well, I pull me a raft and she's ready for floating. Oh, Mississippi, she's calling my name. The catfish are jumping, that paddle wheel thumping, black water. keeps rolling on past just the same. Pour back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moons, keep on shining on. Pour back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moons, keep on shining on. Pour back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moons, keep on shining on me. Keep on shining your light. Gonna make everything pretty, mom. Gonna make everything alright. And I ain't in no worries, cause I ain't got no worry at all. If it rains, don't care, it don't make no difference to me. Just take that streetcar that's going uptown. Yeah, I like to hear some funky Dixieland and dance a little honky tonk. And I'll be buying everybody drinks all around. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me. Keep on shining your light. I'm gonna make everything pretty, mom, I'm gonna make everything alright. And I ain't got no worries, cause I ain't in no hurry at all. Yeah, I like to hear some funky Dixie, then pretty mama come take me by the hand. I like to hear some funky Dixie, then pretty mama come take me by the hand. I like to hear some funky Dixie, then pretty mama come take me by the hand. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on. Roll back water, keep on rolling, Mississippi moon, won't you keep on shining on me. Keep on shining your light. I'm gonna make everything pretty, mama, gonna make everything alright. And I ain't got no worries, cause I ain't in no hurry at all. Here's some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come take me by the hand. I like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come take me by the hand. I like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me by the hand. I like to hear some funky Dixieland, pretty mama, come and take me by the hand.
Here, Doobie Brothers. Nice little relaxed crowd. This one seems like a good one for that.
Sitting in the morning sun, I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships move in, and I'll watch them roll away again. Just gonna sit on the dock of a bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of a bay, wasting time. Left my home in Georgia, headed for the Frisco Bay. 10,000 miles I roam, just to make this dock my home. Just gonna sit on the dock of a bay, watching the tide roll away. Ooh, just sitting on the dock of a bay, wasting time. Looks like nothing's gonna change. Everything still remains the same. I can do what 10 people tell me to do, so I guess I'll remain the same. I'm just gonna sit here resting my bones until this loneliness won't leave me alone. I've got nothing to live for. Nothing's gonna come my way. I'm just gonna sit on the dock of a bay, watching the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of a bay, wasting time.
David Bussin, thanks for coming out tonight. Thanks to, again, to the Hicksville Chamber for having me, and a few people that came both times and had to hear me do some of the same stuff. Appreciate it. I'll be here until about 8:30, so just got a couple more. Here's a little hometown song.
of living is gone. Oh yeah, life goes on long after the thrill of living is gone. Little ditty about Jack and Diane, two American kids doing the best they can.
This is my last one tonight. Thanks for coming out again. I appreciate the support from everybody and sticking around and clapping for a small little crowd here. A little Billy Joel tune here. It's 9 o'clock on Saturday. Regular crowd shuffles in. There's an old man sitting next to me, making love to a sonic engine. I'm not really sure how it goes, but it's sad and it's sweet, and I knew complete when I wore a younger man's clothes. Oh, la da 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 da. Song tonight. Well, we're learning the mood for a melody, and you got us feeling alright. Now John at the bar is a friend of mine. He gets me my drinks for free, and he's quick with a joke, or he'll light up a smoke. But there's some place that he'd rather be. From his face, well, I'm sure that I could be a movie star if I could get out of this place. Oh, la da 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 da. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. Well, we're all in the mood for a melody, and you got us feeling alright. Now Paul is a real estate novelist. He's never had time for a wife, and he's talking to Davy, who's still in the Navy, and probably will be for life. Is practicing politics as a businessman slowly gets stoned. Yes, they're sharing a drink they call loneliness, but it's better than drinking alone. Oh, la da 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 da.
song tonight. Well, we're all in the mood for a melody, and you've got us feeling alright. Well, it's a pretty good crowd for a Saturday. The manager gives me a smile, 'cause he knows that it's me they've been coming to see, to forget about that for a while. And say, man, what are you doing here? Oh, la da da di di da, la da di di da da da. Sing us a song, you're the piano man. Sing us a song tonight. Well, we're all in the mood for a melody, and you got us feeling alright. That's it for me. Thanks for coming out. Have a good night.